Hello everyone, welcome. We have already discussed about the male reproductive system. Now we will be going ahead with the female reproductive system. Just to have a gist on what we have learned earlier, the male reproductive system, we will have a quick go through with the male reproductive system so that female reproductive system becomes easier. Okay, so now if we talk about the male reproductive system, we had the males, there was a testis. Inside the testis, there were testicular lobules. There had been seminiferous tubules into that. And in the seminiferous tubules, they have been connected to the reti testis, which is a network, to vasoferentia and ejecting out the sperms to the epididymis, which moves through the vasa deferens into the urinary bladder and moves through the urethra and ejects the sperm along with the fluids, which is secreted from the glands, Cooper's gland, Proctor's gland, and seminal vesicle, move through the penis outside. So the process of the formation of the gamete, which is sperm, is known as spermatogenesis. It undergoes spermatogonia. There are spermatogonia cells. This spermatogonia cells undergoes mitosis to produce primary spermatocyte. Meiosis one, it produces an haploid. Again, meiosis two, haploid spermatids will be produced, which will get matured into a sperm. All right. Now coming to female reproductive system. So again, as I told you in the male, I told you male reproductive system is outside the body, right? The scrotum is outside, the testis is outside the body. But what happens in a female reproductive system? Female reproductive system is inside the abdominal cavity. All right. So primary sex organ, in case of male, it was testis. In case of females, it is ovary. A pair of ovaries there. So, which is helping in, or which is the primary sex organ in females? What are the secondary sex organs I have? I have a duct system consisting of fallopian tube, uterus, cervix, and vagina. I have external genitalia also. Okay, because outside, once it is coming out, I have an external genitalia and I have mammary glands, which is there in the female reproductive system. Now coming to the female reproductive system, the anatomy of female reproductive system. This female reproductive system, they have two ovaries at either end. So there are two ovaries, and each ovary is covered with a thin epithelium, which encloses the ovarian stoma, which is divided into the peripheral cortex and inner medulla. So there is an ovarian ligament which is connected from the uterus, and then from the fallopian tube onwards, I have a fimbriae, which is a finger-like projection which protects the ovary. This fallopian tube extends from the periphery of the ovary to the uterus. The part closer to the ovary is a funnel-shaped, which is infundibulum, having finger-like projection, which is fimbriae. This infundibulum leads to ampulla. From here, I have the, a structure. I have an ampulla, and which joins to the uterus with isthmus. Uterus is pear-shaped in structure. Uterus opens through a narrow cervix and then to the vagina. The cervix to vagina, this canal is known as cervical canal. This canal is known as cervical canal. So once again, giving you an idea of the female reproductive system, ovary. From there, if I enter, I have a fimbriae. From the fimbriae, it moves to the ampulla. Just think you're holding something. So fingers are your fimbriae and the arm that you have, that is the ampulla. Again, arm, ampulla. Very similar words, arm to ampulla. And then after that, you know, the palm which is there, I'm talking about the ampulla. And then after that, it moves through the isthmus into the uterus. And then after that, I have a cervix to vagina. There's a cervix and a vagina together, which is known as cervical canal. Okay. Now, if I talk about the wall of the uterus alone, just look at the uterus. If you look at the uterus, then the wall of the uterus is having three layers of tissue. The one which is to the exterior is perimetrium. Perimetrium is outside. We had pericarp, so perimetrium, outside. So, perimetrium, which is the external membrane of what? Of the endometrium, okay? Uterus, okay? And then after that, the middle layer is myometrium and the innermost layer is endometrium. The one which is most interior. This endometrium is very, very, very important for the cyclic changes which takes place in the menstrual cycle. All right. Again, if I think about the middle layer, myometrium, they are mainly smooth muscles which helps in the contraction process. Okay. So now what is the external genitalia I have? So, in the external genitalia, we have mons pubis. It's a cushion of fatty tissues covered by skin and pubic hair. So, there is a complete hairy structure and a fleshy zone that we have, which is mons pubis. Okay. And hence, we say that is pubic hair growth, right? The growth which is in the mons pubis. So, in the mons pubis, we have, it ends with a labia majora. Labia majora is what? A fleshy fold that surrounds the vaginal opening. So, vagina, outside that, there's a fleshy part, fleshy fold, which is known as labia majora. So, there's labia minora also. Labia minora is paired fold of tissue under labia majora. So, inside labia majora, we have another fine tissue which is there, which is labia minora. This, the opening of vagina is often partially covered by a membrane called as hymen. So, inside the vagina, there is a membrane called as hymen, which is very, very soft membrane. And the finger, a tiny finger projection which is present in the upper junction of the two, which is labia, of the two labia minora, we call it as clitoris. The upper area, that is a finger-like projection, that is a clitoris. So, outside we have a clitoris, then we have a labia majora. Inside labia majora, we have two folds, which is labia minora. Again, inserted into the vagina, from the vagina inside, we have a hymen, which is a soft tissue. Hymen can easily break out. It's not only during sexual intercourse, it needs to break out. But if a female is into active work, cycling or weightlifting or activities, heavy activities like dancing, hymen can easily break off. It's a so, so, so tender. All right? So, if I see here, what is that things that we have and what is the functions we look? So, I told you ovaries, the basic thing is what? It is the female reproductive organ. So, this is where my ovum will get produced. So, produces eggs and female hormones. Then coming to the fallopian tubes, this is where, you know, the meeting of egg with the sperm would take place. Once that is done, they will get implanted into the uterus where the baby would grow. After that, after the growth of the baby, it will be delivered out through the cervix, that is the it during the labor it will dilate, so through the cervix, and then after that through the vagina. So whether the removal of, whether blood during menstrual flow or with the baby after birth is done through the vagina. All right. Now coming to mammary glands. I told you we talked about the reproductive system. We talked about external genitalia. Now coming to the mammary glands. So mammary glands are what? Mammary glands are basically pale structure like breast that we have that contains glandular tissues and variable amount of fats. So the glandular tissues of each breast is divided into 15 to 20 mammary lobes containing cluster of cells called alveoli. Again, alveoli, we found it in the lungs where there was a interchange of gases was taking place. Here, what is happening? Here we have an alveoli which will secrete milk, which is stored in the cavities or the lumens of the alveoli. So this alveoli will may open into the mammary tubules, and this tubules will form a mammary duct. So there is a duct sac which is being produced, and each mammary duct they will join to form a wider mammary ampulla, which is collected to lactiferous duct through which milk is sucked out by the baby. Okay, so this is how it will be working. So the lactiferous duct is right at the nipple, and who is giving the milk to the lactiferous duct? It is a mammary ampulla. Again, mammary ampulla comes from where? Mammary ampulla comes from the joining of the mammary ducts, which is there. Every mammary glands, they will have small ducts. So from the gland, the tubules would come, they will form a collection of ducts, give it to the ampulla, and from the mammary ampulla, it will move to the lactiferous duct from where milk is being secreted. The process of formation of female reproductive gamete, which is ovum, so that is called as oogenesis. So oogenesis is the process of formation of mature female gamete, which is called oogonia. It started during embryonic development stage when millions of oogonia are formed in each fetal ovary. So at once, the oogonia, the mother cells, the female gamete mother cells will be produced. See, in the male, it is produced each time. Okay, it is a continuous process. Whereas in females, oogonia will be produced at puberty. Okay, and then after that, each egg cells, it will be taking. Okay, it's ovum. So it is being produced. All right. So if I see, there is at the ovary, the whole ovary is here. So at the ovary, we have the oocytes which is being produced, and these oocytes, they will form, there is a structure will be formed outside, and this is known as primary follicles, then secondary follicles. Then I have the tertiary follicle will be formed. From there, it will mature into the graafian follicle. And from the graafian follicle only, the ovum will be produced. Okay? Next. Here, if I come around, as I was telling you, this is very clearly over here. The gamete mother cells, they start divisions and enter into prophase one of the meiotic division and get temporarily arrested at the stage of primary oocyte. So now, again, if you remember spermatozoa, two primary spermatocyte by mitosis, again here also oogonia, two primary oocytes by mitotic division. Okay, then from primary oocyte, it will get arrested in the prophase one, interphase, prophase. Okay, so at the prophase one of the meiotic division. Here, what is going to happen? Here it will stop. And what will happen? Each primary oocyte will get surrounded by granulosa cells, which is there. There is a formation of primary follicle that will occur. So at puberty, 60,000 to 80,000 primary follicles are left in each ovary. Primary follicles, they get surrounded by more layers of granulosa cells, and then I say it is to be secondary follicle, and they transform into the tertiary follicle. In tertiary follicle, what happens? In tertiary follicles, there is an area, cavity is there, which is fluid filled, and that is what I call as antrum. Antrum is the fluid filled cavity which is there inside the tertiary follicle, and this antrum will keep maturing. So there is a maturation of the follicle, the tertiary follicle, which will take place. This I would call it as Graafian follicle. This will rupture to produce ovum. Here is what I will be calling it as ovulation. Okay, so this is ovulation that will take place. So what did we see? We saw the oogonia, it is going to form primary oocyte. Oogonia will form primary oocyte. After the completion, so during this primary oocyte, when it is there, before it forms the secondary oocyte, I have the formation of Graafian follicle and the maturation that will take place. Okay. So from here, then meiosis 1 will get completed. I will have a first polar body, a small polar body, and a secondary oocyte which will get developed. Okay. So secondary oocyte which is haploid. Again, after meiosis 2, what will I have? First polar body will also go undergo meiosis to form two polar bodies, and I will finally have an ovum which is a haploid structure. So this ovum is where it is there? It is inside the Graafian follicle. Okay. Now it will get attached. This ovum would get attached to the uterus. Alright? Okay. Sorry. This will get attached to the ovary, and then after that, there will be a release of the ovum that will take place. The Graafian follicle will get attached. So as I was telling you, at the fetal life, when the child, when they are very, very small, so at the fetal condition inside the womb, the first mitotic division would take place, the mitosis would take place, differentiation would happen with the 2N, that is 46 chromosomes. And then on birth till puberty, we will have the formation of the follicles. So once the follicles are being produced at puberty, what will happen? The meiosis will get completed. So the follicles are not produced. Then after that, there will be meiosis too, and I will have a haploid ovum that will be there. And there are three polar bodies which is there. All right. A haploid will get produced. So that's it with the female reproductive system. Once we complete the female reproductive system, in the next video, we will continue with the menstrual cycle. Thank you.